Getting high FPS and good performance has always been crucial to being a good Fortnite player. If you're playing at 30 FPS, your performance will be severely limited compared to if you had 60, 144, or even 240. I'm your host, Dan, and in this video, we're going to be giving you all of the best up-to-date tips to improve your performance and FPS. But before we start, let's do our question of the day. Today's question is, what FPS do you currently get in Fortnite, and how does it impact your gameplay? Personally, I switched from console to PC and get a consistent 240 now, and I'm really happy I did. However, when I played on console, it really bugged me knowing that I could be getting better performance. Tell us your guys' response in the comment section below the video. If you guys are tired of getting outplayed and looking to sharpen your Fortnite skills, we've got you covered. ProGuides.com is the number one way to improve your skills. We offer on-demand coaching with some of the best players, and if you sign up for our membership, you get access to exclusive content from players like Benji, Kaz, and Mongrel. Click the link below in the description to visit ProGuides.com and start your journey to greatness. Also, hit that like button to show your support. Number one, NVIDIA Low Latency Mode. The first one is for all my PC players out there, specifically the ones with a GTX or RTX graphics card. For this tip, we're going to be turning on a setting in our NVIDIA control panel, which will lower the delay between the movements we do and when they appear on our screen, which will make our game much more smooth and responsive. To enable this setting, first make your way to your desktop and right-click on any open space. Next, click on the NVIDIA control panel setting. Once you're here, a giant menu should pop up with a bunch of weird, complicated stuff. Make your way to the panel on the left and click Manage 3D Settings. This setting should be second from the top. From here, navigate down until you see Low Latency Mode. Click on that and select Ultra for the best performance. Without getting too nerdy and complicated, what this setting does is it shortens the process of getting the movements you make to actually appear on screen by having all frames processed by one unit instead of passing them around every component in your PC. This setting won't necessarily raise your FPS, but it will lower input lag and make your game feel much more responsive. Number two, disabling replays. This next trick is for both console and PC players. This trick will consist of disabling large team, creative, and in-game replays. The reasoning behind this is that recording every single second of every game from every player's perspective is obviously a tough task for your system to take on. By disabling this, you take a huge load off of your device that can be used instead to give you higher FPS, better graphics, and better overall performance. To disable replays, all you have to do is navigate to your settings inside of Fortnite and go to the gear icon and select it. Next, scroll all the way down to the bottom until you see the part labeled replays. Disable all three of these and click apply. Next time you go into a game, your system won't have to record all this data and it'll boost your performance like crazy. Number three, install Fortnite on SSD. An SSD, also known as a solid state drive, is a flash storage drive that runs games faster and smoother than your run-of-the-mill hard drive. If you have a desktop PC, you can easily purchase an SSD for as low as $30, and an SSD will increase your performance by reducing loading times, reducing frame skips and stutters, improve your game stability, and even free up some extra space in your hard drive. You can even install an SSD in a PlayStation 4 or an Xbox. Both are very different in terms of installation, so we recommend that if you're on console and plan to take the SSD route, definitely be sure to do your research and find which ones are compatible with your respective platform. Number four, reinstall Fortnite. If you've had Fortnite installed for a long time, it's quite likely that a lot of excess files and information have been stored in your device that really don't need to be there. And these files can slow down performance and even cause more severe problems like stuttering, lag, and they might even be taking up storage on your device that could be used for other things. The best way to uninstall and reinstall the game on PC is to head into your Epic Games Launcher, head down to the Library tab, and click the three dots to the right of Fortnite. Click Uninstall and follow the process from there. Then simply go back and reinstall the game after. On PS4, locate Fortnite in your library, highlight it, and press Options on your controller. Press Delete and Confirm. Once it's uninstalled, go on the PlayStation Store and reinstall it. For Xbox, navigate to Home, My Games, and Apps, select the Games tab, highlight Fortnite, and select Manage Game, and select Uninstall. By uninstalling and reinstalling the game, you can clean up and verify your files, clear up extra space for other things, and reduce lag and stutters caused by excess files. Following this simple yet easy step might be the solution to a lot of problems you might be having. This whole process can take as short as 30 minutes to complete, depending on the speed of your device and internet connection. Number 5, lower or stretched resolution. Lowering or stretching your resolution is actually a very viable idea, since lowering the amount of pixels on your screen will decrease the load your PC has to render and show to you. To change your resolution, you either do one of two things. If you want to lower the resolution but not stretch it, then the setup is a lot easier, so we'll go over that first. To lower your resolution, head into your Fortnite game and then into the settings menu. On the first tab, the one it automatically sends you to, at the top of your screen, you'll see display resolution. Most monitors and screens are 1920 by 1080 resolution, which is over 2 million pixels for your computer to render. However, by changing your resolution to one of the other two popular choices, either 1600 by 900 or 1280 by 720, you'll be lowering that pixel count to 1.4 million or 921,000. Basically, if you go from 1920 by 1080 to 1280 by 720, you'll be doubling the amount of frames you get, as your computer will have less than half as many pixels to render. If you don't like the idea of lowering the resolution by that much, consider using a stretched resolution. Stretched resolution will basically stretch out your screen and make character models appear larger and easier to shoot, along with lowering the amount of pixels your computer has to render. To enable a stretched resolution, you first have to close out your game, then decide the resolution you want to use. The most popular stretched resolution right now is 1750 by 1080, or just under 1.9 million pixels. That sounds like a lot, but it's actually about 10% less than 1920 by 1080. Another popular one is 1680 by 1080, or just over 1.8 million. If you're really going for the best performance, we recommend one of these two resolutions. So now that you've decided which resolution you want to use, follow my steps closely. If you need to pause the video, don't be afraid to. I'll still be here, I promise. Right-click anywhere on your desktop, and similar to the first step, go to your NVIDIA control panel. Next, head to Change Resolution. This will be located on the left-hand panel. Below all the resolution options, select Customize, and then Create Custom Resolution. The only value you want to change is your horizontal pixels. Switch this to either 1750 or 1680, whichever one you chose at the start. Then click Test. Verify that this is the resolution you want to use, and then press your File Explorer either by searching on the bottom left bar or clicking it on your taskbar. Head to the search bar on the top of the File Explorer and type in %appdata%. Head back to the bar on the top and click where it says App Data and click Local. Scroll down to Fortnite Game, Saved, Config, Windows Client, and Game User Settings. Alright, that was a lot of clicking. Let's take a breather. Wow. Next, you should be in a text document that looks like this. Scroll down until you see your resolution size X and resolution size Y. Change the X value to the horizontal value you put in your NVIDIA control panel, and fill in last user confirmed resolution size X right below it with the number again. Finally, go right below where it says last user confirmed desired screen width and type the number again. Press Ctrl and S to save the file and exit. Finally, in your File Explorer, right-click on Game User Settings and click Properties and tick the Read Only option on. That way the game doesn't modify your resolution. We know that was a lot of work to set up, but stretched resolution is great, and now you know the process to enable it, so you can pretty much use any stretched res that you want. Experiment with a few of them and pick one that not only gives you good performance, but also that you feel comfortable with. Number 6, optimize your in-game settings. Alright, now that we're past all the fancy Windows stuff, we can optimize our settings in the actual game to give our performance one last little boost. Make your way to the settings menu like before and stay on the display page. Don't mess with the resolution, but you can mess with the 3D resolution if you like. This basically changes the quality of the items loaded in, but not the pixels actually loaded. This can help clear up some CPU usage and a little bit on your GPU as well. We recommend slightly lowering this if you still struggle after all the other changes. The best way to get the most frames possible is to turn all the main graphics settings to low or off. Shadows are harmful to your gameplay as they can make it harder to see people. Anti-aliasing makes everything look a bit cleaner but slows down performance heavily. Textures aren't necessary and won't help your gameplay that much. Effects will get in the way and clutter everything up. And post-processing will add an extra unnecessary step to when your PC is processing frames. The only option that you should really experiment with is view distance, depending on how far you're looking to see your opponents. We recommend setting this to medium or high for the best mix of good frames and not having to load way too much. Set it to low and you won't see far enough, or set it to epic and sacrifice your FPS. Finally, VSync should be disabled for performance as it sacrifices FPS for looks, and motion blur is optional depending on your preference. The only other setting you need to turn on is allow multi-threaded rendering, as it splits all the drawing work across multiple threads of your CPU instead of depending solely on one thread. This will drastically improve your performance if you're on a multi-core PC. Number 7, upgrade your system. So you've tried everything on this list. If you still struggle to get consistent frames and quality, we recommend considering a few upgrades to your hardware. The three main parts that play a role in your performance are your CPU, graphics card, and your RAM. We'll give you a few recommendations for each so you have some options. First, for your CPU, there are a bunch of great CPUs that'll give you a good bang for your buck. First, at the higher end, we have the Intel i7-8700K, clocking in at about $380 on Amazon. This CPU can be overclocked for better performance and is overall a great choice for gamers who want the best performance and aren't afraid to pay for it. Second, we've got the i5-9600K at $250. With fast speeds, 6 cores, and 6 threads, you can't really go wrong with this one. The last CPU on our list is the Ryzen 5 2600. This CPU is often referred to as the king of budget CPUs, as it has 6 cores and 12 threads, and is only slightly slower than the i5-9600K, at a surprising $120. If you're on a tighter budget but looking for good performance, this is the CPU for you. Next up, we have the graphics cards. Looking towards the higher end of the spectrum, we have the GTX 1080. This card provides amazing speed, can handle upwards of 240 FPS with ease, and can even give some leeway if you want your graphics setting to be on high or max. While the 1080 is spectacular, it does come at a heavy price of about $530. However, if you're looking a bit lower, we have another great option for you, the GTX 1060. If you're looking for a bit of room for settings and still want upwards of 150 FPS, the 1060 is your best choice. Coming in at around $250 to $350, it's a great choice for someone who wants the most out of their system at a good price. Finally, one of the easier selections is the RAM. RAM, also known as random access memory, is important for Fortnite. Epic Games recommends a bare minimum of 4 GB, but 8 is more preferable. However, it could never hurt to go just a bit higher and have some extra, which is why many gamers go for 16 GB. If you're looking to stay modest with 8 GB, we recommend the Corsair Vengeance LPX 8 GB, clocking in at only $37. Corsair Vengeance RAM is one of the highest quality and provides great numbers and performance. If you're on the higher end and shooting for 16 GB, we recommend the same exact thing, but double. The Corsair Vengeance LPX 16 GB RAM kit, which will only put you down about $80. Overall, the hardware in your device might be one of many things holding back your performance, and if you follow all the other steps and still struggle with it, we definitely recommend putting in the money to make some upgrades. Alright, let's recap everything really fast before the end of the video. First, enabling the low latency mode will decrease input lag and make your game more responsive. Second, disabling replays will take a heavy load off of your device while you're in-game, as your device won't have to record everything. Third, installing Fortnite on an SSD will greatly increase your performance and decrease hitches and stutters. Fourth, doing a complete reinstall of the game can help get rid of unnecessary or corrupted files, clear up space, and improve performance. Fifth, enabling a lower or stretched resolution will lower the amount of pixels your computer has to render, directly increasing your FPS. Sixth, optimize your in-game graphics settings to medium or low to decrease what your device has to render. Finally, if you do all the above and you still struggle to have consistent high frames, we recommend making some upgrades to your system to give yourself that extra little edge. Alright guys, it's been fun, but unfortunately, that's gonna be it for today's video. By using these awesome settings and tricks, you can guarantee that your device works to its maximum potential, and that you can get the best quality and performance. We really hope you enjoyed this video, and that this one helped you out. Also, don't forget to use code PROGUIDES when making any purchases in the Fortnite shop to support your ProGuides team, and comment down below if these tips helped you and what you'd like to see next. We aim to bring you guys the highest quality Fortnite content around, so do us a favor by dropping a like, and maybe even subscribe to the channel. Finally, show ProGuides.com some love for bringing you this video. Once again, I'm your host, Dan. You can find me everywhere at Daniel Lammerman, and we'll see you guys next time.